Murphy. We're here at the Doko Pacific's new headquarters in Timuni. I am with JK, Jonathan Kriegel, who is the president and CEO of Docomo Pacific, and he's going to give us a tour of this wonderful building. And for old-timers like me, you'll remember this as the old Ben Franklin building. It ain't Ben Franklin anymore. So JK, take it away, sir.
Thanks, Lester. Welcome to Docomo Pacific. So we'll take you through the building. We've got five floors in the building, and Docomo Pacific is occupying the first four. So why don't we start? This is our reception area. I want to greet everybody. Say hi today. Immediately, as they come into the building, we're creating spaces for engagement with our customers, with our community partners, making it easy for people to collaborate. So we already have three conference rooms available. We've got the Red Room, we've got, right, Monaga over here, and Fusion, which celebrates our merger of the fixed and mobile businesses here at the end.
And the idea for having conference rooms, this is where your staff can engage the customers directly? Or?
Customers, partners, vendors, get together to work cross-functionally. So actually in the building, Nestor, we've got 14 meeting rooms, and all of the executive offices also serve as meeting rooms, and we'll see that as we go through the building.
Cool. Yeah.
Okay. So let's go next. We'll do, actually, I'm sorry, let's cut back and do a quick talk, a quick walk through the retail stores. Yeah, take a look at what's out here.
And I want to mention that you do have a little function tonight, yeah?
Oh, we do. So tonight is the grand opening. So we've been in the building for about 10 weeks now, and we've worked out all the little details, all the little kinks, and we're now ready to welcome the community into this building. You know, this place is so filled with memories for everyone. When we first started to do this project, so many people approached me and said, wow, it's great that you're taking this iconic building and bringing it back to life. So we really feel honored that we had this opportunity to partner with MV Pangolinan, with, you know, they're our great landlords, and they've been great partners and hosts to us, with Future World, who did all the renovations, and with Rim Architects, who helped us do the design.
And I'm sure you've heard this story. This building housed the very first escalator on Guam. So as kids, we were like so excited about being able to ride an escalator. So it was really
absolutely. And we've heard many stories, Nestor, about the escalators. We needed extra floor space, and we needed to bring the building up to sort of 2018 safety codes. And so we've removed the escalators and replaced them with two sort of elevators that help move us around. And we also have two really cool stairwells we'll show you because we use the stairs a lot. This is our flagship retail space. It's meant to be an area. You can see it's very open. You can see that everything is out and accessible. If you walk over here to the handsets. You can see that if you walk into the space, you can engage directly with any of these handsets, with the VR goggles. We want people to be able to engage with the technology. So it's not behind glass, it's not inaccessible. It's in a place where you can reach it and try it yourself and see if it works. Back here, we've got space where we take care of our business partners and customers. Right, so this is the top 10 table, and so these are the top 10 devices at any given time. So you'd have the Apple 10, you'd have the iPhone 8, you'd have the Samsung 9 all here on the table. Plus, we've got some hero devices from in sort of the medium to lower end phone, our Figo devices, which are fantastic. And we feature them all here, and you can see that if you just walk up to one of these devices, they're already running and accessible, and you can try things out for yourself.
And I probably figure that the customers appreciate the ability to be just, you know, get down in there and
do it. No, see what it does, right? So if there's an app you like and you want to see how it works, if there's a website you go to on a regular basis, you can go right in, surf on your own, and figure out if this device is going to be good for you. Oops, hold on, let's get back to the main screen.
Great.
All right.
More.
Oh, wow.
And so this is where we serve our business partners. So if you happen to be a business or enterprise customer and you need to engage with Docomo Pacific, you come here and one of the associates can, you know, there's a place for you to wait. There are, again, top 10 devices, office phone systems, and this is where we'll engage with you and provision your devices and give you service. Access to the unmatched customer experience here at Doug Mother.
I really like that you've got golf on the TV.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Ron is golf crazy, that's for sure.
Yeah.
All right. So the other thing that we feature here, Mr., is that you can show up and people visit us for a repair. So if you've got an issue with a mobile phone or one of your boxes, this is the tech zone, and these are the bright young people who actually diagnose and then repair issues with devices, especially handsets. And so we're doing all of this work here. Our team is trained to work on Apples and Samsungs and Figos, so if you have an issue with your device, you can come and see the tech zone folks. And actually, over half of the folks who come in, I'll leave with their device fixed before they depart the store. So we don't have to give you a loaner anymore, largely because what we're discovering is that more and more of the problems are just software related, and we've got the tools to actually do that testing and make the fixes on the spot.
Yeah, and I'm sure they appreciate the ability to have their phone when they walk out, yeah?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
No one wants to give up their phone.
Exactly.
No. Look, the story I like to tell is that these days, it's easier for people to leave home without their wallet. You will easily spend a day outside the home without your wallet, but everyone will turn around and go back and get their phone.
Yeah, it's true.
All right. So, D, where should we go now?
Let's go up
to two.
Yeah.
Okay, come on up. So, let's go to the zone.
And why is it called the zone?
So, the zone is named by some of the associates here. It's the place where people can gather for lunch, to meet between meetings, to relax a little bit in the afternoon. People hold meetings and collaboration things going on there. So it's really just an all-purpose space. But what it really does is it allows us to gather together at our old offices. We didn't have a space where we could put 150, 200 people into one location, and now we have it.
Is that kind of like a modern sort of idea for a workplace where we have these open spaces as opposed to, you know, everyone's kind of locked into their cubicles?
Exactly. Yeah. So one of the things that we did here is that we were trying to bring best practices to Guam. So we sent Nate Tanula and two of the people on his people operations team. So this is what we're calling human resources these days. It used to be personnel, then it was human resources, now it's people operations. So we sent Nate and two of his team members, come on in, to Silicon Valley. And they visited with companies there. And one of the things they learned is that a very open space like this, where you can see people have got their kids in here after school, people are having lunch. Generally, you will also see people. When I walked in here this morning at about 8:30, there were a group of four people sitting there with their laptops open, working on a project together. If you wanted to just sort of come and hang out quietly for a little while, you could do that in one of these chairs in the back. So this space, it's multi-purpose, and you can move all of this furniture can be moved around. So, and we don't, none of it is fixed to the floor, and we encourage people to come in here, and if you need to reconfigure it, just do it and go. And so this is how we try and sort of bring a bit of sense of community and family to the business. On Friday, one Friday afternoon every month, we have a band come in and we'll serve a little bit of beer and get people together and just socialize.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So yeah, trying to, you know, bring Silicon Valley best practices to the Marriott.
Yeah. So the design of the office is purposely, like for example, this building, is all well-researched and there's a purpose behind each?
To almost everything, so almost every part of this building There is some bit of research behind this that Nate or our colleagues at RIM, our partners at Vodafone, we leveraged Vodafone. This is the global mobile phone operator. Well, now they're a broad-based telecommunications operator, and we are a Vodafone partner here in Guam, and so we also leverage the fact that they operate in 30 countries around the world. They have 90,000 employees, so they have a lot of best practices, and so we also learn from them. So we try to look around the world and figure out what is best practice sort of for a sort of technology company today, and to bring that sort of those ideas here into our business. So one of the things you'll notice is that lots of glass. There are no longer walls. There are no longer offices with walls that you can't see in. Every room in this building, including my office, it's all glass. You get to see who's working. You get to see who's doing what. And I think that that's an important element that we learned from sort of our travels.
Yeah, so it eliminates like kind of the closed off atmosphere.
It's very elitist. Oh, I don't get to see what you're doing, or we're behind. You know, so everything is open. Everything is transparent. This is people operations. So if you want to come and join the Docomo Pacific team, one of these days you'll find yourself in that room. This is one of the three training rooms we have here. We call our training operations here the University of Docomo Pacific.
I was just going to say it looked like a university classroom.
Exactly. So it's the University of Docomo Pacific. We've got interactive whiteboards. So with that whiteboard, you can actually broadcast pictures to the internet or be linked to the internet. You want to put maps up there. You want to have web content. You can engage there. All of these tables can be moved. So the other day, they were in an E configuration for a certain kind of training that was going on. So everything is very, very flexible. Lots of power in the floor. So if people are in here, we had a 1 week training, sales training with some off-island trainers who came in. People needed to plug in, bring their laptops. So there's lots of power and connectivity around. So again, very flexible spaces so that we can adjust on the fly.
And I imagine that you can do a lot of remote learning or remote training.
That's exactly the point. Because if you wanted a video conference and you wanted to tap into somebody in the UK at Vodafone, or you wanted to tap into somebody on the US mainland, you can broadcast on that screen and everybody can sit here and it's interactive.
Cool.
Okay. So now we'll head off to see some of the workspaces. So one of the things that we do is that we're trying to provide a variety of spaces for people to work. If you work in an open environment, every now and then you need a bit of privacy. Maybe you're talking about something that's confidential, you're having a confidential call with a partner, if you're in finance or something like that, you need some private space. So there are these telephone booths on each floor, and the booths accommodate two people. So if you can come in here, you bring your laptop, you can set up Skype for Business and either do video conference or voice conference, but you have a little bit of privacy. So here's another telephone booth. This is one of the main conference rooms that we've got. Again, everything is in glass. You'll notice in front of every conference room, we've got a tablet that allows you to look at the schedule. So actually, there's nothing going on here, but if this room was busy and you did need a place to meet, you could actually tap the map and it would show you where you are and which rooms are already booked. So the room called the Merge is booked. But all these other three rooms, and we were just in the University of Docomo Pacific, it's green and available. So you can quickly tell what's available, and you can do this throughout the building. So if you wanted to go up to the fourth floor, you'd also be able to see that actually right now the main conference room is open, but the other two conference rooms are being used at the moment.
That is cool. I see you got a different theme for this one.
So each of the rooms has a different theme. So this one is meant to sort of bring back the early days of gaming in Super Mario Brothers. And look, it just creates a slightly more lively environment, right? You know, days are long. We're looking for inspiration and a little bit of energy. And by having, you know, a surrounding like this, it sort of is a little bit unusual. We're hoping that'll spark some new ideas. Make it a little bit more fun.
Right? It looks fun. It looks like a real fun room.
And then, of course, if you got a little free time on your hands, please come and, you know, play Super Mario Brothers. Exactly, with the team.
This would be my favorite room.
that one is down the bar. You can see that more conference rooms. Everything is glass. Hey, G, how are you? This is our finance area. We're providing collaboration space so that, again, if you need to come out of your workspace and you need to meet quietly with other people, here are some spaces. We have a Promethean board. This is another interactive whiteboard. If people need to do that, need to have access to information that you broadcast or put up a spreadsheet or you go out to the internet, that's all available.
Cool.
So, typical. This is one form of open office, but it's got sort of low barriers between the desks. We do this in finance because we have accounts payable. Some of the people who are here working on payroll, they need a certain amount of privacy. But most of the other areas that you'll see, there won't even be the plastic separators. It'll all be completely open. We'll show you that as we go on to the other floors. So you can see that in the stairwell, that's what we're trying to do is we're trying to make it, you know, something that people feel excited to use the stairs. So one of the things we do is we sort of have a policy that says if you're going one floor up or two floors down, we want you to take the stairs. So it's one up, two down is sort of the policy, but in order to encourage people to come into the stairways, we brought local artists and asked them to sort of bring a bit of their imagination, bring a bit of local culture to us here at Tocoma Pacific.
Plus, it's healthier for them.
And absolutely, it's much healthier. It's much healthier. Right, so I'm on the fourth floor, so when we first started, that trek up a couple of times a day was tough, but it's getting easier as the days go by.
You have a little bit of cardio.
Exactly.
And who that would be?
So I'm going to, Dean will be able to help me sort of give you the names of all the artists, but I think each floor is a different artist, although one artist did two of the floors.
Do you know who did this? Oh, Josh.
Josh, yeah. Lindsay Kane. Down here.
Lindsay Kane.
Artwork. So here we are. This is the fourth floor. And in this room, this is really typical of what we're talking about. We were sort of talking about a truly open plan. So you can see there are no dividers between the desks. You can see that people can see all the way across the room. Collaboration spaces, more interactive whiteboards, lots of spaces on the walls where you can write things. So for example, this is paint. That's actually a coat of paint on the wall, and you can see that people, see what's going on down here, people are just using this wall to post things, write things.
Here, you can smell it. Is it?
All right, so here's somebody who's sort of put up some sort of sales numbers and things like that that they're doing. So, but they can erase it, and you know, just like a whiteboard, okay? So trying to create lots of spaces where people can do whatever they need to do, but in a sort of more engaging, more collaborative way. So we've got everybody from our carrier wholesale team, our enterprise business team, the marketing team, and our in-house advertising agency, which we call the Ad Ninjas. Everybody's here. And one of my favorite stories is that the folks who work on our roaming plans on the marketing side don't often, in our old office, they had to go outside and walk across the parking lot in order to find the people who negotiate the wholesale deals with the other operators in the other countries. And after about the first week here, somebody in marketing said, "This is great, because the wholesale team is just right here. We see them all the time, and we started having conversations about how we can collaborate to get lower rates in certain countries, which we can then sort of offer as lower rates and promotions to our customers.
And as you mentioned that, I was going to ask you, I think one of the decisions behind establishing a new headquarters is the efficiency side.
Absolutely. I mean, this makes it so much easier for people to get along, to see who's here, to collaborate. Other than the hardware of the building, we're also launching Microsoft Office 365, so new software to enable collaboration and sharing of documents and being able to work without people being physically in the same space. And working with our team up at Harman, our colleagues in the CNMI, our partners at Vodafone, our vendors in Japan and the mainland. So using Microsoft Office 365, so for example, Skype for Business, now everybody who's got a laptop, everybody who's got a mobile phone, if you've got the Skype for Business app downloaded, you can do video conferencing, you can loop people in, you can start a call that's voice, add in the video at a later stage if you need to, send messages to people while you're real time on the call, share documents, put your screen up onto the conference so that other people can see it. So these types, it's not just the hardware, it's also the software that's enabling us to collaborate better.
Okay, hold on. Battery change.
Oh, okay.
All right.
No worries.
You guys are good.
How are you doing your battery?
My battery's
We've
good.
Got chargers.
My battery's good. D saved my life.
Oh, excellent. Excellent. All right.
Real quick.
No worries. Okay, so we got another telephone booth down here. Conference room, lots of whiteboards. And so normally, okay, so today we've got a lot of visitors coming through. We've cleaned the whiteboards, but on any given day, these boards are just filled with the projects people are working on, ideas that people are thinking about. So you can see. So somebody sort of worked on something and you're walking by, you know, hey, you can add your voice to that project in a much easier way than we were able to ever do before.
How many employees do you guys have?
So we've got 400 associates in this building, Nestor. We've got 650 in the whole company. So we've got about another 150 up in our Harman facility. And then the other 100 or so, 110, are up in Saipan, Tinian, and Rota. So yeah, it's
a lot of folks.
There are a lot of folks in the business, but we've been expanding, you know. If you think about the submarine cable that we built, TISA, between Guam, Saipan, Tinian, and Rota, we only had 30 people in the Northern Marianas before we built a TISA. But now that we've expanded our networks and we've had to grow the number of people. So we went from 30 to 110 just in the Northern Marianas. Okay. So let's take a look at where the senior leadership team works. Office for one of our chiefs. That's Tom Valderrama, our chief marketing officer. Hey,
Tom. How you doing, Tom?
Sorry to interrupt. So you can see that the way these rooms are set up is that there's sort of a thin bench where people can do a little bit of email if they want to, but most of the time people are sitting at this central table, which is really a conference table, right? It's really a meeting room because the majority of the work that we do, it's not sitting behind a desk working by ourselves anymore. It's working collaboratively, so we wanted to make sure that if one of the leaders need to get together with their team, work together with other departments, that there are plenty of spaces to do this, right? So effectively, each one of these offices is a meeting room.
Like you say, a lot of glass.
A lot of glass, you can see all the way through. We don't have our window shades in yet. So, you know, there's always one thing you gotta do at the end of the process. It's beautiful at sunset. So this is where I work. And as you can see, you know, if I'm doing email, I'm there. But most of the time, I spend my day sitting here and, you know, meeting with other people and talking about projects, video conferencing. We've installed video conferencing here, like in all the other rooms. And that's really the way we're doing things these days.
Well, let me ask you, is this a preferable setup to maybe 10 years ago when you were working perhaps in a different company, in a different corporate environment?
Yeah, so for sure, the idea that where I work is effectively where I work, not by myself, but with other people. I think that's just becoming it's the mandatory way to work. If Think about what telephone companies do today. Every product or service we develop, it's essentially software development. And when you think about software development, that's a big collaboration amongst people who are like Liz Henry and Connie Cruz, who do our retail stores and our call center, people who in our finance department, our IT people, our network people, in order to roll out a new service, change a rate plan, all of these people need to come together on a regular basis to make that project work, and where can we meet? So increasingly, the kind of work we do, it's not you by yourself in your department, it's you with other people and almost always working cross-functionally. Okay. Here we go. So as I was saying, Esther, so the building has, we've got 14 conference rooms of different sizes, meeting areas. Oh, actually, here's something you can take a look at. So you can see on that screen that there it says reserve for DocoMotion, reserve for DocoMotion. We have a program called Magic Info that allows us to broadcast content to all the screens in the building. So if we wanted to show everyone one of the new TV commercials that we're about to launch, or if we're about to launch a new promotion and we want everybody to know about it, we can push that out to all of the screens in the building.
Like your own closed circuit television system.
Absolutely,
yeah?
Absolutely.
Wow.
It's a great way to communicate. Okay, gentlemen. All right. Oh, the making of the paintings. Break rooms look like this, places for people just to get together and have a quick bite. We have quiet rooms. So we have six quiet rooms in the building. So for mothers who need to express breast milk, for people who just, you know, you get a migraine and you need to take a rest, or hey, I just want to take a nap for 20 minutes in an afternoon. And people do use it for that. You know, come in and rejuvenate, right? Recharge the batteries and then come back out ready to go. So we've got six of those around the building.
We need one of these stations. Maybe five.
Our camera
would you guys have mat rooms?
Oh, is that right? Our like, yeah, okay. We need that. And so here, this is the one Mariana's room. So this is our main conference room where we meet as a senior leadership team. And if our shareholders in town or we've got big important partners, this is where we will meet. And you can see we've got screens around the room, so regardless of where you are, seated at the table, you've got good visibility into what's going on. And we can have software that allows us to do different things on different panels. So if we were doing a video conference and we wanted to have the video conferencing, the image of the other side on the front screen, we could then broadcast the spreadsheet or the PowerPoint presentation that we were working on the side screens. And so you can mix it up as necessary.
Very impressive. So I guess it's setting you back a couple hundred bucks?
Yeah, exactly. We're going to have to ask our IT folks what this stuff costs. But look, I think this is it's a fair point about what this costs. It costs us over $10 million to do this renovation and to bring the technology. But this is a long-term investment for us, right? So we've just built a submarine cable. We're working on a data center. These are very, very long-term investments, and I think that the investment in our new headquarters is got to be appropriate to match those other investments we're making in our network.
And, of course, this is the fourth floor, and then the fifth floor is open for rental.
Absolutely. So the floor with the best views, it has almost floor-to-ceiling windows, is available for rent. So it's 12,000 square feet, and we would be happy to sort of lease that as one floor or to break it up into smaller pieces, but we're really hoping that we can find like-minded tenants who want to come in here and enjoy this space. Obviously, because we're running a phone company here, we've set the building up in such a way we've got dual fiber routes coming into the building. There's Wi-Fi everywhere. There's LTE in the building. We've got generator backup. So I think if you're thinking about coming here, there are many sort of benefits.
Communication will not be a problem for you.
Should not be a problem. Should not be a problem.
JK, thank you very much. Congratulations on the new building. It's beautiful, wonderful, and I'm sure you and your employees really appreciate what you've done here.
Nestor, thank you, and thanks to KUM for coming to celebrate with us on our grand opening. We appreciate that.
All right, Facebook World, there you go. The new Docomo Pacific offices or headquarters here in Timuni. See you guys later.
Thanks.